is never communicated to individuals. This statement was being proved to be absolutely correct by fingerprint experts all over the world. No two persons has the same fingerprint pattern, even in their twins. And with my 18 years at Moscow, I've been trying to discover if this is all wrong. But no way, for 18 years, the number of fingerprints that I have come across, so numerous, thousands, millions, and in the whole world, of about 7 billion, can't see two people having the same type of finger. God is the greatest statistic. In 1823, John Pockington, a Hollander and professor of anatomy in his thesis, named 9 standard types of fingerprints. These 9 patterns of fingerprints are 1. Arches. A-R-C-H-E-S. Arches. Or arch. Arch pattern. 2. Tented arches. Tented arches. It's like a tent. We will come to it. That's why they call it tented. The tented arches, the pattern is like a tent. It goes like this and comes down. Goes again and comes down. It's like a tent. But why the arches move from the other left to right or right to left without a recovery? That in the call. So that is how we normally identify patterns. If it's ash pattern is in your hand, there will not be any reach at the recall. It will either move from one side to the other, like you know that it's ash pattern in your hand. But when it's moving from one side to the other, you call it loop. Either loop. Honor or radial loop. Tented is number 2. Number 3 is loop. Loop patterns. Then 4 is plain wall. I think this thing is going around. Plain wall is that pattern that has 2 letters. Plain wall has 2 letters. It can be spiral. Can be round, circular. Round spiral. You are knowing the patterns now. That's plain wall. Plain wall has 2 letters. 2 letters, plain wall. Delta at the side, delta at the side. Plain wall. That's 2 letters. That's what we call. Then we have central pocket loop wall. Lateral pocket loop wall. Then twin loop. Twin loop is also a wall. But the pattern is in a very twin shape. It's not regular, it's not circular, and it's not spiral. But it has 2 letters. So is this a man, John E. Pocketty, that described the 9 patterns? How many patterns have I given you now?
7.
The 8th one is accidental pattern. Why the last is composite. These are the major 9 patterns of fingerprints. There are more than this, but it's the major 9 patterns. Because from the loop, from the tented arch, you have different types of patterns. From the loop, you have honor loop and radial loop. Honor loop is a pattern on the right hand. If it's moving towards the right hand side, If they are all bending or coughing to the right hand side, you call it honor. But if it is moving to the left, you call it radial lute. And if it turns its head like a head pattern, you call it mutant lute. So move on, please. Okay, John E. Pukenji. P-U-R-P-E-N-J, a Hollandian professor of anatomy. In 1856, another German, Hermann Welker took the print of his right hand. Years later, in 1897, about 41 years, he printed the part again, and in the following year published these prints. Apart from the expected evidence of an advance in age, the ridges of the later prints are identical with those of the print made 41 years before. Fingerprint does not change. If you are 5 years, your fingerprint is recorded. When you are 100 years, 200 years, 1 million years, it remains. Does not change. The pattern does not change. Two people attempted to change the pattern in their fingerprint. That is Loka and Mutkosu. They tried it by using hot water and they burnt their hands completely. So there's no way you can change the pattern. And to change the pattern of your hand.
What was the effect of the bolt?
Once it's burnt and peeled completely, if the dermis, you know how the epidermis and the dermis, the outer side is the dermis. If the dermis is gone, it's destroyed, the epidermis will also bring it out. But if the epidermis is destroyed, you can't get any impression in that finger.
Okay, with that, such person, there's no evidence that he touches anything.
And such person, there'll be no evidence. Just like somebody wearing a hand glove. But that must be a serious punishment for such decisions. Sir William Hester was the district officer of Bufli in Benga State in India in 1858. He was confronted with numerous impersonations among Indians. Hester started the practice of recording handprints of Indians on contracts to prevent impersonation and repetition of signatures. Started this. When he learned that people were impersonating, started recording their fingerprints. The contract. Any contract he made, record his fingerprints. So that people were not impersonate again. You know you can forge signature, but you cannot forge fingerprint. If you have any book, probably you want to write your name on it. Once you have put your thumbprint, you have written your name. There is nobody on earth that can claim that. Since no two persons in the world yet said fingerprint. Once you put your thumbprint on any document, it's your problem. If you see it with somebody, can I accuse the person? The thumbprint is already there. It's a permanent signature which we carry. Another Englishman, Sir Francis Galton, who corresponded with Sir William Hester, wrote the first textbook of fingerprints in 1892. In the book, Galton devised a practical system of classification and filing of fingerprints. Much of his material is still employed in modern practice. In 1893, British government became interested in fingerprints and set up a committee known as Asquith Committee, British government, named after the Secretary of State, to investigate the subject. 1893. The committee was impressed by his studies in Galton's laboratory and indicated as much in the report dated 12th February 1894. As from this date, fingerprints became officially adopted in Britain a supplementary system to the Bertillon system. There was a man called Alphonsus Bertillon. When he was discovering fingerprints, he said, if fingerprint is not available, what else can somebody use? His name is Alphonsus Bertillon. So, okay, he will use measurements. If there's any suspect arrested, he will measure the length of the leg and the breadth of the leg. He will also measure the fingers and the length of the fingers. But that is a good method. You can use that one to convince somebody in the court. But you can use that, you know, as maybe some facts that you cannot use in the court to convince somebody. It's called Bertillon system. Using measurements. You measure the finger, you measure the leg. There are some areas that it will prove worthwhile. Maybe in the office. The office. Somebody stole in the office. And you know you have different maybe even foot marks is there. You can measure the foot. After measuring the foot, I have some suspects in the office to be able to compare that. You may not take the person to court. But if you take the person to court, it will not be scientifically proved. That this fingerprint is scientifically proved in the cut. In 1900, Sir Edward Henry, who succeeded Sir William Hesley as district officer in India, published the system in book form. The following year, he was called to New Scotland Yard as Assistant Commissioner of Police. In the criminal record, his name is there, if it's identified. But if you say untraced, it means it's not traced in the criminal record. We have so many definitions here, but because we tell you. We have CRO, which is Criminal Record Office. CRO, Criminal Record Office. We have CCR, Central Criminal Register. We have a recidivist. A recidivist is a convicted person who has previous conviction. An inmate is someone who has no knowledge and fingerprint. Inmate. We have web fingers. You will ask me how do we record web fingers? Split tongue. Having web fingers. Then why do we take fingerprints, or why do we record fingerprints? That's the area that I want to hear. I was thinking we have 1 hour, 2 hours, and no, you are going to be